Welcome to my channel. My topic is sperm attraction. The sperm attraction is basically based on the chemotaxis movement. So what is chemotaxis movement? Like this egg, like for example, this is the egg of sea urchin. It will release this chemical. This will release the chemical. When it releases the chemical, it will attract the sperm. This egg will release the chemical, and that chemical will attract the sperm toward the egg. So this kind of movement is known as chemotaxis movement. What happened in 1978? The scientist Miller, he take the egg of the sea urchin. He examined under the microscope and he examined the mechanism of sperm attraction, its chemotaxis movement, its acrosomal reactions, fusion between egg and sperm, block of polyspermy, activation of egg metabolism. These all are been examined by taking the egg of the sea urchin by the Miller in 1978. Here, like if we take the example of egg of the sea urchin, it contain the jelly coating. It is coated by the jelly like substances. This is the jelly coating all around. This is the jelly coating, and this jelly coating only the chemical is released. This chemical only decide which kind of sperm it will attract. There are many sperm. Either when we talk about the sea urchin egg or the sea urchin sperm or the sperm of the fish or there is a sperm of any other. So this sea urchin will attract only the sea urchin sperm. This is the means the chemical which is released, that will be different in every species egg. So in sea urchin only one kind of chemical is released, and that will attract the sperm. So this is the type of sperm it will attract. Now when it complete its second mitotic division, it get fully matured, then only it is applicable to attract the sperm. Now this is the criteria. First criteria is that there should be a completion of second mitotic division, then only it will attract the sperm. And second thing is that which type of sperm it will attract, that will be decided by the chemical which is released by the egg. This is the testes of sea urchin. Here the pH is low, that is 7.2, and the carbon dioxide concentration is high. Here a huge amount of sperm is there. Now they are immotile, they cannot move. So when they move from testes to outer environment, like in sea water, when they move out, this is the sperm, it's move out to the use ocean. What happened? pH increases, that is from 7.2 to 7.6. like for example, we human beings, like if we are living in the Jammu Kashmir, here the temperature is quite low, is very low, but when we go from Kashmir to Delhi, that gradually the temperature increases and our body start giving responses. Likewise, this sperm, when it move from lower pH to higher pH, inside the sperm there would be the activation of dyne ATPs. This ATPase is the enzyme which is responsible for breaking of adenosine triphosphate. Means it consists of three phosphate. What happened when it get break down? It will produce 2-phosphate. it will produce two phosphate product, that is adenosine diphosphate with inorganic phosphate. So one phosphate will be released out in the form of energy, and this energy is taken up by the sperm. Now it get motility. Now it is now the sperm is very much happy that I got the motility power. Now I can move here and there. Once more, this is the testis of sea urchin. Here the carbon dioxide increases, level of carbon dioxide is high, pH is low, that is 7.2, and huge number of sperm is there. When it move from ants, and initially it is immotile, means it is not motility is not there, means they cannot move. So this sperm will move from testis to outer environment here in the seawater. Gradually the pH increases. When the pH increases, the body start showing it response. There is the activation of DINATPase. DINATPase, what happened? This enzyme will break down the ATP, adenosine triphosphate, into the adenosine diphosphate with inorganic phosphate. And that one phosphate, from 3 phosphate to 2 phosphate conversion is there, and one phosphate will be released out in the form of energy, and this energy is utilized by the sperm. So it will get now the sperm get the ability to move. Now it's very happy that I got the power of motion. Now where should I move? Where to move? Where is my target area? Where I will move, and where is my destiny? Now this can be decided by the protein, that is RESET protein. In sea urchin, hence I have told you that each and every species egg, this each and every species egg, they contain their own kind of protein. So when we talk about the sea urchin, they having in this jelly coating, they contain the protein, that is RESET. But when we talk about the blue sea urchin, they contain the protein, that is SPARECT. They contain this protein. They contain this protein. Whereas when we talk about the sea urchin, they contain RESET. Whereas when we talk about the blue sea urchin, they contain the SPARECT. This protein are the sperm activating polypeptide. They will move and bind with the receptor. A receptor which is present onto the head membrane of sperm. They will bind with the receptor. This RESET protein, they will go and bind with the receptor which is present onto the head of the sperm. After binding, what happened? This sperm is get attracted toward it. Now it will attract. This is the portion of attraction. The sperm is attracted with an egg. Now when we talk about the structure, here is the middle piece. This is the middle piece, and this middle piece contain the mitochondria, and this mitochondria only give energy to the tail for the motion. And this is the neck part. This is the neck part which contain the calcium ion. So the calcium ions are stored, and this is the nucleus where this will be released onto the egg. And acrosome, here the enzymes are present, proteolytic enzymes, degrading enzymes. They used to degrade the membrane. This jelly coating will be degraded by the enzyme which is present onto this acrosome portion. Next, here, this is the egg of sea urchin. They will release the RESET protein. They will release the RESET protein, that is the sperm activating, that is the sperm activating polypeptide. This jelly will release the RESET, that is the sperm activating polypeptide, and they will be attached onto the receptor of the sperm head membrane. This is the sperm head membrane. membrane which contains the receptor that is known as the guanyl cyclase. This is known as guanyl cyclase. This is the guanyl cyclase. This is the guanyl. GC is the guanyl cyclase receptor. Guanyl cyclase. After this reset bind with this receptor, what happened? There is this GTPA is used, and they will activate the cGMP. After activation of cGMP, there is an activation of calcium ion channel, and it will take all the calcium ion from the environment toward inside the cell, inside the cytoplasm of the this sperm. Here the calcium ion concentration increases, and this only allow the sperm to move toward the egg. Now they will get the destiny that where I have to move. The sperm, they will get the direction through this, with the help of this reset protein. After binding with the receptor GTPA, they will use the GTPA, and there is activation of cGMP pathways, and after that there will be activation of calcium ion channel. This calcium will be moved inside the cell. Here the concentration of calcium ion increases, due to which the sperm will move toward, they will get the direction and they will move toward egg. So this is the concept. This is about the sperm attraction. In next session, I will be telling you about the acrosomal reaction. So do like and share my videos. Thank you.